Hello, dear all. Good evening. A quick message. I first thought I'll write it, but then my heart said no. Just say it. And so I'm saying it. I was just, I've made a lot of groups and all. And one of the groups I was just reading. I just chanced upon it to go through, because otherwise so many groups, then sometimes things get missed. So I was just reading where someone has messaged about some parent in Pune, parents to an autistic kid, and father is critical and he is in the ICU, and mother also has corona and she's quarantined at home with the kid. And it just came to my heart to make this message. So this message is a humble appeal to all parents. Dear all, corona has taught us a very important thing. None of us comes with a guarantee card of how many breaths God Almighty has assigned or given us. We don't know. The one who's making this message right now, for all I know, in another 15 minutes, I might just kick my bucket and I'm done. We don't know. You know, such uncertain is life. And then the message said that, you know, they need a plasma donor and they need the medicine because we've run out of oxygen. In the morning, I myself was messaging to some of my known people, you know, who are in the medical fraternity, in the morning, for some parent who was requesting that if you can arrange for some oxygen in Delhi. And it is so sad that I could not help, because that person who's running a chemist shop said, I don't have it, it's finished, and it's not there anywhere in Delhi. So the situations are bad. And we can pray and we can stay safe. But at the same time, what I'm saying is, the reason I wanted to make this message, and I tend to get digressed from my topic, so I'll come back, is that none of us comes with a guarantee card, okay, that you are going to be alive for these many years period. You're not going anywhere. We don't know. You don't know. I don't know. Okay. It becomes imperative that our kids stand on their feet. Okay. Now, when I say, I don't mean literally, what I mean is that our children have to be capable enough of living their lives without us as soon as possible. And it starts now, or it starts yesterday. Okay, so we are not going to be complacent. Another thing very important, you know, out of love for our children, my kid is struggling with something, trying to do, I will jump in. I will open the door for the kid, hold it there. The sad part is, I don't know for how long will I be available to open the door and stand there. Damn, build skills, build ADL skills. ADL is such an important thing. And I tell all my, there are 10 groups running, math, English, EVS, this, that, different variants of math, different variants of English, language group, you know, social is starting. But I tell every class, I tell the same thing to all my students. Let the focus be ADL. So if your math is there, then it should be ADL driven, that the kid knows how to go to the grocery store, knows how to calculate, knows how to give how much change, knows how to get back. Okay, for the younger kids, you know, we're not expecting the kid will go to the grocery store, but for a kid who can do it, it's absolutely important that you stop saying that to yourself. You stop saying, you wait, I will get. You want water? I will get for you. My God, our children don't even know where cups and glasses are kept in the kitchen. Forget dying. If suppose for 2 days we are quarantined, or the kid is away, or for some good reason the kid is to themselves, they wouldn't know from where to get katori, where to get glass, chamach. They're stranded. What good is a love that is going to strand the kid? So start thinking on those lines. My kid needs to be independent by the age 18 or 20. Totally independent, like capable of going to another place and hiring a place and staying and studying. Have that vision. You know, don't think, oh, autistic children don't do this. See, if destiny is that he is not supposed to do it, or she is not, they will not do it. Okay? But then, neither you have seen the destiny nor I have seen the destiny. What stops us from trying? Maybe the destiny is that he might be able to do it, or she might be able to do it. Right? So what we really need to do is start building up now, so that by the time they're 17, 18, and God willing, by God's grace, we have that kind of time to ourselves, We live to see them living independently. Yeah, so many people say, what after me, what after me? Please don't think what after me. Do it now. Do it now when you're alive and kicking. And Corona comes as a huge reminder of this. So every age, if your kid is very young, do those ADL skills which are needed. If your kid is older, do those skills which are needed. Don't let go of ADL skills. Your main focus, my kid must be independent in terms of language, in terms of communicating with outsiders, in terms of doing their things. Okay, so age-wise, don't be that loving parent who will jump in to provide everything and feed the kid and, oh my God, my kid has a problem, let me help. For how long? I don't know. You don't know. Nobody knows. Yeah, love is what love does. Get them to be independent, that they're not stranded when we're not around. God bless. May we all live long. May we all live to 100. May we all defeat Corona. But still, keeping that in mind, work. Thank you. Bye.